Before we hear from the man of the hour, let us first turn our attention one more time to the video board as we look back at his Hall of Fame baseball career.
No one knew at the time that the triple Reds rookie second baseman Pete Rose collected for his first major league hit on April 13, 1963 was the first step on a journey that would culminate in Rose finishing a 24-year career with more hits than any player in the history of the game. But that is precisely what happened. Here, Edward Rose, the River Rat from Cincinnati's west side, took aim at a record that was long considered to be unassailable, the 4,191 career hits recorded by the great Ty Cobb. Along the way, Pete accumulated virtually every accolade and award that a baseball player can receive. He was an all-star, an MVP, a batting champion, a gold glove winner, a world champion. And then there were the records, dozens of them, franchise records and league records and all-time baseball records.
Chad kicks and he fires, Rose swings.
Filled to overflowing with the name Rose. But the awards and accolades and records tell only part of the story. For Reds fans, it was often less about what Pete accomplished than how he accomplished it. He was not blessed with an abundance of natural ability, but made certain to make the absolute most out of everything he was given. He played with a grit and drive that were so much a part of his approach to the game that it became his nickname. Charlie Hustle, and he had fun. No one seemed to have as much fun on the field as Pete. It was impossible to miss. He was always quick to flash that trademark Rose grin, even in the most pressure-filled moments. He simply loved to play the game. But perhaps more than anything, he was one of us. He was ours. For generations of Cincinnatians, watching Pete Rose play baseball made them Reds fans, instilling in them a passion for the club that has never wavered. Cincinnati's own, Peter Edward Rose. He was the captain of the greatest Reds team ever fielded, and established records that likely will never be broken. And he did it all with a style of play that combined joyful exuberance and fearsome intensity in a way not seen before or since. Indeed, many men have worn the uniform of the Cincinnati Reds, but no one ever wore it quite like Pete Rose. And it is all but assured that no one ever will again.
To the microphone, number 14, Pete Rose.
God bless the Commissioner of Baseball.